Welcome back. Two former presidents of the bar have also been speaking about the forthcoming NBA elections. In an interview with Channel TV's Emmanuel Ereyi in Port Harcourt, River State, former president OCJ Okocha SAN believes that the guidelines are in order.
I have read and digested the guidelines issued by him, and in my honest view, they are totally in compliance with the provisions of the Constitution and standing orders of the Nigerian Bar Association. And if that be so, can anybody complain that those guidelines are not fair to any of the candidates? So the converse of it is that, in my humble opinion, the guidelines being constitutionally articulated must be fair, must be seen as fair to all the candidates contesting elections come July 2014.
What about the one banning the pasting of campaign posters and visits to branches? How will candidates sell their manifestos if they are denied that access?
You know, even from when I was president of the Nigerian Bar Association, this is over 14 years ago, and you remember I contested twice, these guidelines have always been in place. But I always maintain that rules and regulations are made for human beings. And you know, when there is an infraction which is not materially contrary to the rules and regulations, we tend to overlook them. Candidates can sell themselves by any means, by the internet, by emails, by, and you know, they limit campaign material to a certain size, A4 paper. Because you see, some candidates have run these elections and printed huge billboards, huge posters, and then they are pasting their campaign materials all over the place. Sometimes it makes the venue very, very untidy. Sometimes it gives the impression that we have lost all sense of proportion, all sense of decorum. This is an election into the offices of a professional association. It's not a cash and carry thing. We are not reaching people who are not illiterates. And you know, by the time anybody gets to the point where he thinks or she thinks that she is eminently, he or she is eminently qualified to be NBA national officer, we must have known the person. So who are you selling yourself to? To the delegates or to the general public? So I think that by and large, I have no reason to quarrel with the stipulations in the guidelines.
The candidates are also worried that the guidelines do not provide for a list of delegates to be provided to candidates. What do you think about that?
Well, you see, candidates always try to, you know, push their luck. Let me use that term advisedly. They should look at the Constitution and standing orders of the Nigerian Bar Association. If the Constitution does not provide, and the standing orders do not provide, that each candidate will have a list of delegates, then what is the basis of them demanding to have the list of delegates? Indeed, in my humble estimation, it will be deleterious to the election to give them list of delegates long in advance of the election, because that would give them an opportunity to begin to try to unduly influence the delegates. The provisions, as we know it, is that at the point when we get to accreditation for the elections proper, the delegates list is published, pasted on notice boards all over the venue. Anybody who has any complaints that his name or her name is not there is perfectly entitled to say, my name is not there, I'm a delegate nominated by so-and-so branch. So I think they are just crying their wolf, just to raise the stakes, as it were. You know, candidates, as I say, like to push their luck. I don't think there is any legitimacy in that complaint.
Do you think there's any cause to worry as to whether there is a predetermined outcome to this whole matter?
This is the elections of the Nigerian Bar Association. Nobody can have a predetermined outcome in place, or is maybe planning to put in place a predetermined outcome. Nobody will even know who the delegates are until the branches submit their list of delegates. Tell me who can begin to predetermine for those delegates that they don't even know what and who they will cast their votes for. I think it's another, you know what they say, loud cry of wolf when there is none in the vicinity. There can be no such thing. Nobody can determine the outcome of the elections until after votes have been cast and duly tabulated and counted.
You think there could not be ground for manipulation even at the branches where the delegates' lists are being collated?
I don't believe so. I have been a chairman of a branch, Port Harcourt branch, when it was a branch that comprised what we now have in Rivers and Bayelsa. You follow? Rivers and Bayelsa states. We nominate delegates. And you know, the delegates' list is announced at our general meeting in our branch. And I believe that must be what other branches do. The complaints that many branches have had, indeed some candidates have had over the years, is that, oh, the chairman usually dictates who should be the delegates. And you know, this is a matter of freedom of association. And whoever the majority decides should go forward as a delegate is who eventually becomes a delegate. So, I do not believe there is any legitimacy in all these complaints.
What kind of president do you think the delegates should seek to elect?
Well, always, and this is something we have had as part of our tradition in the Nigerian Bar Association, that the NBA ought to be seen as the winner at the end of the day. So, with that in mind, the delegates should be looking for a president, looking to vote for a president who will continue to uphold the motto, the aims and objects of the Nigerian Bar Association. A president who will truly serve the bar and truly, you know, give impetus to what we say is independence of the bar. In the recent past, as you well know, particularly in my branch here, Port Harcourt, we have had difficulties where some of our elected officers did not appear as if they were acting in furtherance of the interests of the members, in furtherance of our motto to uphold the rule of law, in furtherance of that desire on our part as an association to protect the independence of the bar. So, in my humble estimation, that should be our focus. Any candidate who we believe will continue to uphold the aims and objects of the Nigerian Bar Association and uphold the rule of law and the independence of the bar. The truth of the matter, however, is that the NBA always believes that the right candidate will emerge, because we know ourselves. We know those who have the track record, and their track records indicate that they will serve the bar. So, I have no worries. At the end of the day, and you know, there has been controversy about zoning. We have said it is for the West. And happily, all the five candidates who have so far indicated interest are from the West. Four from the Southwest, one from what we now call the Midwest, because they say they want to be a zone. But we said, no, we can't create more than three zones, at least not now. For reasons of the past and how we got to the sorry situation that ended up with the NBA being moribund for nearly 6 years, we believe that we should operate this zoning system, east, west, north. Thankfully, all the candidates are from the West, and I believe that the delegates will select the best man, or the best woman for that matter, to become the next president of the Nigerian Bar Association.
Now, last week Friday, I caught up with former President Wole Olanipekun SAN at the Federal High Court in Lagos. Despite the heavy rains, he shared his thoughts on the forthcoming elections.
consider what the NBA is as at now. The NBA is no longer meant for lawyers, strictly speaking. The NBA has become national. The NBA has become global. Law associations all over the world have gone far beyond fighting for bread and butter for their colleagues constituting their primary constituencies. Although we must always defend that, we must protect it, we must espouse it. I've been there before. I can identify where the shoes pinch, and I know what it means to be an NBA president. An NBA president must be prepared to face powers and principalities, to challenge authorities. An NBA president should not be compartmentalized. An NBA president must know his onions. Therefore, my plea, my appeal to all our colleagues is that let us forget our very narrow interests, primordial interests. Let us sustain the Nigerian Bar Association. It's very important. People like us, we've sacrificed for the bar. We have rules, we have conventions, we have traditions. We have ethos, we have ethics, we have agreements, we have covenants. For the NBA to be able to tell government, to be able to tell international institutions, to say respect conventions, respect laws, respect agreements, NBA must be able to do that. The charity of the NBA must start from home. And what I've been saying as a leader of the bar is that we cannot afford to destabilize ourselves. God forbid, and may it never happen. I speak as a former president of the Nigerian Bar Association. I speak as somebody who wanted to be president of the NBA since 2000. I speak as somebody who crisscrossed the length and breadth of this country. I was in Sokoto, I was in Maiduguri, I was in Jos, I was in Bayelsa, I was in Porakot, I was in New York, everywhere. And OCJ Okosha was doing the same thing at the same time with me. We had a NEC meeting in Lafia, Nasarawa State. Very early in the morning, I had a knock on my door. OCJ Okosha was there. He entered my room. He locked the door. And I asked him, OCJ, what exactly is wrong? He said, Wole Baba, you are my brother. You are my egbon. You and me cannot contest. We cannot afford to have a repeat of the 1992 debacle in Porakot. OCJ said, Wole, I contested and lost in 1998. So I'm pleading with you. Step down for me. You are my senior. He was saying, I'm cutting him. He's alive. He's alive. And let him deny it. And he will not deny because he's a gentleman. He's a gentleman. He said, you are my egbon, you are my senior, both at the outer bar and inner bar, and in age. But you will step down for me. Please. If I don't contest this year, I will not be able to contest again. Let me finish the job that I started in 1998. And between the two of us, with God Almighty supervising us, I said, OCJ, I will step down for you. In the interest of the bar, not in my own interest, I stepped down for him. I contested in 2002 and won. Why can't we repeat it now?
It's on this note that we end today's episode of the program, but by all means, let's keep the conversation going online. Please share your thoughts on the issues of the guidelines and the forthcoming elections. I'd particularly like questions you want me to put to the candidates on their programs for lawyers and the legal profession. Send me a mail, a Facebook comment, or a tweet. please use the hashtag NBA Decides. And don't forget that you can find this episode and past episodes of the program on our YouTube page. I'm Shola Shieli. Thank you for watching.